It is my great privilege to have the opportunity to introduce Minister Kostis Hatzidakis. Minister Hatzidakis is one of the key ministers in the government, and he's also a vice president of New Democracy. He has a long and distinguished career in politics. He has held several ministerial positions over the years, and the energy sector that he's taking care of now is one of the most important sectors for Greece, and also a sector of particular interest for international investors, as witnessed by the inflow of investment in that area. So, Minister Hatzidakis, thank you for being with us. Please, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the basic priority of this new Greek government, the Kyriakos Mitsotakis government, is to convey everywhere the message that Greece has become a business-friendly country. And this holds true for all sectors of the economy, including, of course, the energy sector. As regards especially energy, we focus on two specific priorities. First of all, market liberalization where needed, particularly in the electricity sector. And secondly, promoting privatizations. At the same time, it is obvious that we cannot overlook two additional parameters as we are shaping our energy policy. The first one is the geostrategic position of our country in the map, especially when it comes to natural gas. The second is the green transition, in line with the European Union's priority to drastically reduce greenhouse gas emissions by 2030 and make its economy climate neutral by 2050. Towards this end, we aim to make the best use of the new European financing tools, mainly the Recovery and Resilience Fund. We are proud to hear, and I would like to underline that, from the European Commission that our recovery and resilience plan is one of the most ambitious they have seen so far. And we are also encouraged to see the strong private sector interest that has been expressed for the utilization of the loan instruments offered by the Recovery and Resilience Fund. We view all this thing as a vote of confidence for our energy policy. Let me begin by briefing you about the two privatizations that are in progress as we speak. The privatization of our electricity distribution system operator, HEDNO, or DDE in Greek, which forms part of our strategy for the modernization and digitization of our electricity system. Our government has decided to offer 49% of the company with significant minority rights via an international tender. The tender process was initiated today by PPC, the main electricity company in Greece, the sole shareholder of HEDNO, and is expected to be completed within the first half of 2021. Apart from this privatization, another major effort is the one concerning the assets of the country's largest nickel producer called LARCO. Nickel is a fundamental component of lithium-based batteries, which are of key importance for the electric vehicles and the green energy transition as a whole. The initial non-binding express of interest is open until the 11th of January, and the whole process is expected to be completed by June 21. I should also note that we have ongoing bids for the privatization of our natural gas company, DEPA Commercial and DEPA infrastructure, as well as for the privatization of the underground natural gas storage facility of South Kavala, which will become the country's first strategic natural gas storage infrastructure. And this leads me to the natural gas projects, which enhance Greece's geostrategic importance. Our country is becoming the most important transit hub for the transportation of alternative natural gas sources in southeastern Europe, thanks to the following initiatives. First, the start of the Trans-Adriatic Pipeline, TAP, operations through the Greek natural gas supply company, DEPA, allowing Greece to receive gas from Azerbaijan by the end of this year, in a few days. These deliveries will signal the beginning of the commercial operation of the EU's southern gas corridor. Another major project is the Greek-Bulgarian natural gas pipeline called IGB, which is expected to start commercial operation by the third quarter of 2021. Furthermore, the liquefied natural gas regasification terminal of Alexandroupolis will open up a new gate for alternative gas sources to Southeast Europe, linking Alexandroupolis with IGB, the Greek-Bulgarian pipeline, and other interconnectors. This will extend the reach of flexible alternative LNG supplies all the way to Hungary and Austria. All these projects will help ensure the energy security of Greece and the EU and constitute, of course, a necessary stepping stone in the process of energy transition. Speaking about energy transition and the greening of our fuel mix, I would like to point out the following elements. First of all, at the heart of our plan is our commitment to shut down all lignite power plants until 2028 at the latest, with all plants currently in operation closing by 2023. This is not driven strictly by environmental criteria, but also by economic considerations. The electricity generated from lignite units is no longer economically viable in Greece. Our commitment is combined with an extended investment plan to guarantee a social and economic just transition for the regions affected by this change. The decommissioning of the lignite units is in mainland Greece, and the diesel burning units in the islands are the two main pillars of our decarbonization roadmap. In order to achieve this, we have presented a 5 billion euro master plan, which will be completed, complemented by investment incentives. This total amount will include state money, funds from the Just Transition Fund and the Recovery Fund, as well as loans from the European Investment Bank. The decarbonization process entails many business opportunities. Some examples of this is the collaboration of the Greek state with Volkswagen in order to turn Astypalea into a green and sustainable island, as well as the deals of PPC, our electricity, the main electricity company, with foreign energy companies like RWE of Germany and EDP of Portugal to accelerate its foray in renewable energy. The transition of the lignite regions entails business projects in various areas, for example, clean energy, sustainable tourism, agribusiness, R&D, industry, and commerce, and we already observe a lot of investor interest. The same holds true for the renewable energy sector, and this makes us confident that we will achieve the ambitious targets we have set to increase the penetration of renewable energy sources in our energy mix to 35% by 2030, up from approximately 18% today. This practically means that the country aims to install 9 gigawatts in order, of new solar and wind power capacity in the next 10 years. It is indeed very satisfying to see the significant investment interest in renewables, especially in innovative projects that include hybrid production units, energy storage, offshore wind, and even hydrogen. We are currently working on creating the necessary legislative framework to support such investments according to the international best practices. I should also mention that one of our main priorities is the increase of energy efficiency. Towards this direction, we are currently implementing the most ambitious initiative for energy saving in homes, which has been met by very strong demand from the public. Our plan is to secure 3 billion euros in funding coming from the recovery fund in order to expand the scope of this program to businesses and the tourism sector and generate significant positive synergies among the sectors of our economy that are involved, including construction. These initiatives also help support the digitization of the Greek energy grid, since we provide incentives for investments in smart building technologies. Finally, another area of major growth potential is electrical mobility, for which we introduced Greece's first legislative framework. Our goal is to have one in three new vehicles powered by electricity in 2030. In order to achieve it, we need to develop the necessary infrastructures in terms of chargers and units producing batteries. To this end, we already adopted special investment incentives. This is practically a new market for which we also observe a lot of investor interest. Ladies and gentlemen, I have tried to briefly describe to you the investment potential in the Greek energy sector. I believe that you are convinced that we have a clear strategy to make advantage not only the geostrategic position of our country, but also of the opportunities that exist in the new era of green transition. And I'm positive that in the coming years, we'll see our country attract a wide range of investments that will transform our economy and help us build a more sustainable future. Thank you very much.
Minister Hatzidakis, thank you very much for your keynote introduction to the energy sector. Very insightful, very interesting, obviously. And now we have two great panels following on the energy sector. Again, thank you very much for being with us today. Thank you.
Thank you.